same microphone you use to measure the time delay, you can use to measure the frequency response of your speakers. You have your binaural microphone, you have your microphone pre-amplifier to get a line out. Also here, switch off the amplifier, the pre-amplifier, or disconnect the microphones with the preamp to prevent the Larsen effect. Connect it to a free line input of your DSP device. Also here you can use a monaural measuring microphone, but it's not recommended because everything you hear with your left ear, you also hear with the right ear, only in time delayed and a little bit different. So the important measuring is the summing of the left and the right ear. Measuring the frequency response. I've connected my microphone on input 5 and 6. I check in the mixer. Input 5 and 6 is not connected to any speaker, so I have no danger to produce a Larsen effect and to destroy my speakers. I go in the measuring menu. I press the button microphone connected, so all inputs are muted. I choose my input 5 and 6, where is my microphone connected. I press the button set mixer to connect the signal generator for measuring, and I press the button RTA start sine sweep to start the measure. After the measuring is done, I can display the left and the right channel of the measuring, the left and the right in-ear microphone. I can show the logarithmic sum, the summing of the left and the right channel. I can do a binaural analysis. It means corrected summing of the left and the right channel. In this way, the human hear the frequency response. You can display the reference curve, and you can shift the reference curve in the frequency response sheet. You can measure your full speaker system, the frequency response. Also, you can measure only a single speaker or only a single system on one side. But also here, the measuring is with both ears, and the important thing is the green line to adjust your equalizer.